Quite good, is it?
How does that work?
I don't know, Dad. I'll tell you what, Dad. It really growls down there, doesn't it? this is invented by...
It was just at the time when they were into a transition where they had to sell their own advertising. Big Breakfast probably put a point on the ratings. That's very important in advertising terms. And the result was that actually throughout the schedule they started doing things that were very definitely influenced by the Big Breakfast, such as Don't Forget Your Toothbrush, which are TFI Friday.
Good evening and welcome to TFI Friday. Friday night's live on Channel 4 once again. This evening's show is...
Beneath its cheeky exterior, TFI Friday was just good family entertainment. Where the Word had actively set out to break taboos, the new show just flirted with them.
Look, Ewan, they're all moaning at your film. Yeah, it's not fair. Go on, have a whinge back at something else. What's on your mind?
Let's have a go at the Conservative government.
Oh, blimey.
For a start.
I'm in trouble
let's
again.
Let's have a go at them for just fucking everything.
No, you can't! Ewan, I'm in so much
trouble.
Do you realise how much trouble
Class
I'm in
A
now?
Mistake.
Do you realise how much trouble... Once again, I apologise for the language of my first guest.
Ewan McGregor was a new breed of film star, launched onto the big screen by Film 4.
You seen The Flat?
Yes.
And you like it?
Yes, it's great.
Yes, it is, isn't it? And we all like it. The room's nice too, don't you think?
Yes.
Spacious, bright, well-appointed, all that sort of stuff. All that sort of crap.
Well, yes.
Yes, so tell me, Cameron, just tell me, because I'd like to know, what on earth could make you think we'd want to share a flat like this with someone like you?
Choose life. Choose a job. Choose a career. Choose a family. Choose a fucking...
Film 4 was now enjoying the most prolific and commercially successful period in its history.
Do you know what they call me?
What do they call you, sir?
Farmer George, do you know what that is?
Impertinent, sir.
No, sir, love!
Its films seemed the perfect expression of the channel's desire to be intelligent yet popular. Then, in 1997, a series came along that showed, for all its commercial success, it hadn't lost its capacity to shock. Brass Eye raised questions that tested even the channel's nerve and its own moral compass to the limit.
When Brass Eye came along, you know, the absolute truth of it, I think that two eras and two cultures clashed. Chris Morris was new, alternative, radical, satirical, oppositional comedy. Michael Grade, was to some extent of a more traditional old school. He was an entertainer.
Brass Eye was a series of spoof campaigning documentaries, which traded on the willingness of celebrities and public figures to do almost anything to get on TV.
Buy sterile drugs.
Carla the Elephant is currently... curled up in a kind of a grey ball. Her trunk is actually stuck up her anus and they're not trying to help her. So we must. I'll give you another one that you can cut in later. I'll just say that. Okay. And you can cut it in later. Yeah, got the elephant, go to somewhere else, all right? And still rolling? Come on, help us get that trunk out.
Channel 4's boss, Michael Grade, had misgivings about Brass Eye, both its methods and its message. But his programme team backed it, and so he let them go ahead. One sketch, however, was banned.
Next week, Peter Sutcliffe takes to the West End stage to star in a musical of his own life.
Co-star Marigold Blenny says he's a kind man with a sense of humour.
He's always jumping out at you. Oh. Like this.
So what's the audience going to make of it?
I think they'll go away thinking, maybe he's really misunderstood man. Maybe that, you know, 20 years ago he was taking the piss.
Because of victims' families and so on, I just felt they crossed a line that I didn't feel was defensible.
On Grade's instruction, the series was broadcast without the Yorkshire Ripper sketch.
Because we were quite a close-knit production team, we used to watch all the shows round at each other's houses, and we watched the crime one round at the director's house, and afterwards Chris said, oh, have a look at this, and frame by frame he went through the relevant bit.
He replaced the offending sketch with what's called a flash frame, which it's very hard to see
when a programme's broadcast and the flash frame said, Grade is a cunt.
Chain to the radiator.
Nobody would have noticed what Chris Morris had done, and we've just recreated how he did it. So if you missed it, here it is again.
Been chained to the radiator for some time.
But it didn't escape Michael Grade's attention.
The series went out, and whether by luck or whether he was prompted, somebody had stopped their video recorder and caught a subliminal frame in which the message was superimposed on the transmitted programme, Michael Grade is a see you next Tuesday. And that caused a furore. Subliminal frames are against the law, and he broke the law.
Michael was really cross at the time, and I believe that his words were, get me his beating heart on a plate, and I had to point out that this was not permitted under the contract, although, of course, I was then tasked to review that.
I took it in good humour at the time. It was a pain in the neck because I just want to get on with my life and my work, you know, not having to spend all my time dealing with him, you know, and the issues that he was creating. Childish, really.
The spectacular row over Brass Eye was the last Grade had to endure at Channel 4. After nearly 10 years, he left, having professionalised its output, but with its risk-taking DNA intact. And there was more change to come. The whole country was about to enter a new era.
Hi, Tony Blair. Thanks for agreeing to this.
I haven't read anything like it before. You know, the story of Blair and Brown, which...
we should meet.
...dominated everything for the last few years.
I want to know your decision.
The next age of Channel 4 coincided with the age of Tony Blair. The Deal was a film by Peter Morgan, which plotted Blair's route to the top.
It was really a story about friendship and betrayal. It wasn't that I wanted to write a story about contemporary British politics. It just so happened to be that the story of friendship and betrayal that I was interested in telling involved the two most powerful people in the country, or would become the two most powerful people in the country. Of course, all politicians are human beings. That envy and betrayal and jealousy and friendship and resentment should feature in their lives as strongly as in anyone else's, and that themes of a Cain and Abel story that was going on right under our noses had an emotional dimension that hadn't been explored.
I've hated the last few days.
Why? In years to come, you might come to see them as your finest hour.
And you recognise, oh, I see, that's who those people are, and it just made sense of the world. I mean, the truth is, it's sort of about two celebrities, and it caught that personalisation that Blair embodied.
On your way out, say hello to that girl.
Who is she?
The new girl in EastEnders. Forget about politicians. That's real power.
But the French, when we showed the film in Biarritz, described it as a film about the death of socialism, which, of course, none of us had set out to make, but I guess you can see how they got there. You know, Tony Blair's obsession is the mantra with modernisation.
A new dawn has broken, has it not?
New Labour, new Britain, new, modern, new, new.
We have been elected as New Labour, and we will govern as New Labour.
And linguistically, it became a world in which socialism as a word was banished, tradition banished.
Life was fine, full of the wonder of the spring.
But it presented the old-style Channel 4 with a bit of a dilemma. After 15 years looking for trouble over their right shoulder, they now had to reset their compass.
I remember when Tony Blair came into office, and there was a sense that I was thinking, well, what on earth am I going to do now? Until I realised that that's exactly what he was thinking.
The government has identified a problem with the product previously marketed and sold as New Labour. A fault has been discovered in the central command chain